Good morning. Welcome to Trinity. I want to give a special welcome to our guests. If you're a guest this morning, if you'll look out in the pew rack in front of you, you should find an information card. If you'll take that and fill that out, place it in the offering plate later on in the service, we'd appreciate it. And then we'll get it in the office and we'll send you some information about our church and we'll just communicate a little bit and come buddies. So send us some stuff and we'll send y'all some stuff and we'll communicate a little bit. Now I'd invite all of us to take our bulletin and we'll look at the announcements and we'll go down through there and highlight a few things and go over a few things that are happening around our church over the next couple of days. There's no evening activities on the upcoming Wednesdays, so they're listed there in the bulletin. But we do have a Christmas Eve communion service on Saturday. The pre-session music is listed there at 4:30, and the service starts at 5. Now, I don't know if you've noticed, but on Hughes Road, there's a lot of churches. So if you come out Saturday, the traffic's going to be pretty heavy. So just factor that in when you're driving and give yourself plenty of time to get here and arrive safely. The college Christmas party will be at the Brand's house. It's listed there. White chicken chili and hot wings from Crickets. Yeah, we know what you like. So come on out. The details are listed there. Notice the announcement going on down through there, the end-of-year contribution information for next week. Over on the next two Sundays, no 8:30 worship and no Sunday school, only the 10:30 worship, and that'll be on Christmas Day and for January 1st. There's t-shirts and sweatshirt order forms and samples in the gathering area. So pick up those forms and fill them out. Information's listed there in the bulletin. Tonight, child care for Sunday school classes having their Christmas parties from 5 to 8 p.m. Pizza will be served. Now listen, we've got a little weathering stuff, okay? So if roads start closing and things like that, check your e-group and we'll put something out about that. But if we start having roads close, we'll probably, you know, not have the child care and that'll probably not happen tonight. Okay? That makes sense? Great. So this time I invite you to stand and pass the peace of Christ and greet one another. Today I've got a confession. When I was a youth, I got kicked out of youth choir. I know it comes to a shock to y'all, a lot of y'all. Technically, I didn't get kicked out but technically I got sent down to help with the snupper or the snack supper early, like about an hour early each week. The point is, I wasn't a strong singer. Actually, I'm an okay singer. Part of the problem might have been a behavior problem. Anyway, I got sent out of youth choir. Today, we at Trinity celebrate the coming birth of Jesus through special readings from the Bible and songs. We call this service Lessons and Carols. We'll be doing a lot of singing and celebrating. I promise no one will be asked to leave early to help with the snack supper. All are welcome here today. Welcome to Trinity. Thank you.
So today's scripture reading is from Isaiah 54:10, and it reads, "Though the mountains be shaken and the hills be removed, yet my unfailing love for you will not be shaken, nor my covenant or peace be removed, says the Lord, who has compassion on you."
Please pray with me. Dear God, thank you so much for this time we get to come together to worship you. Thank you for our friends and family that are sitting around us. Please help us to remember what this season is truly about. Amen.
Our first lesson this morning comes from Genesis chapter 3, verses 8 through 19. Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden. But the Lord called to the man, "Where are you?" He answered, "I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." And he said, "Who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?" The man said, "The woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree, and I ate it." Then the Lord God said to the woman, "What is this you have done?" The woman said, "The serpent deceived me, and I ate." So the Lord God said to the serpent, "Because you have done this, cursed are you above all livestock and all wild animals. You will crawl on your belly, and you will eat dust all the days of your life. And I will put enmity between you and the woman, between your offspring and hers. He will crush your head, and you will strike his heel." To the woman he said, "I will make your pains in childbearing very severe. With painful labor you will give birth to children. Your desire will be for your husband, and he will rule over you." To Adam he said, "Because you listened to your wife and ate fruit from the tree, which I commanded you, you must not eat from it, cursed is the ground because of you. Through painful toil, you will eat food from it all of the days of your life. It will produce thorns and thistles for you, and you will eat the plants of the field. By the sweat of your brow, you will eat your food until you return to the ground, since from it you were taken. For dust you are, and to dust you will return." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us now sing together hymn number 76, O Come, Emmanuel. Please stand as we sing together.
O come, O come, Emmanuel.
Please be seated.
The second lesson is from Genesis 22:15 through 18. The angel of the Lord called Abraham from heaven a second time and said, I swear by myself, declares the Lord, that because you have done this and have not withheld your son, your only son, I will surely bless you and make your descendants as numerous as the stars in the sky and as the sand on the seashore. Your descendants will take possession of the cities of their enemies, and through your offspring all nations on earth will be blessed because you have obeyed me. May God bless the reading of his word.
At this time, our pre-K and our kindergartners are invited to exit for children's worship as we sing together hymn number 79, Blessed Be the God of Israel. Please stand as we sing together.
Our third lesson today comes from Isaiah chapter 9, verses 2, 6, and 7. The people that walked in the darkness have seen great light. They that dwell in the land of the shadow of death, upon them hath a light shined. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Of of the increase of his government and the peace there shall be no end upon the throne of David and upon his kingdom to order it and to establish it with judgment and with justice from henceforth ever and ever and even forever. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will perform this. May God bless the reading of his word.
Hear now the fourth lesson from the book of Isaiah, chapter 11, verses 1 through 9. A shoot will come up from the stump of Jesse. From his roots a branch will bear fruit. The Spirit of the Lord will rest on him, the Spirit of wisdom and of understanding, the Spirit of counsel and of might, the Spirit of the knowledge and fear of the Lord, and he will delight in the fear of the Lord. He will not judge by what he sees with his eyes or decide by what he hears with his ears, but with righteousness he will judge the needy. With justice he will give decisions for the poor of the earth. He will strike the earth with the rod of his mouth. With the breath of his lips he will slay the wicked. Righteousness will be his belt, and faithfulness the sash around his waist. The wolf will live with the lamb, the leopard will lie down with the goat, the calf and the lion and the yearling together, and a little child will lead them. The cow will feed with the bear, the young will lie down together, and the lion will eat straw like the ox. The infant will play near the cobra's den, and the young child will put its hand into the viper's nest. They will neither harm nor destroy on all my holy mountain, for the earth will be filled with the knowledge of the Lord as the waters cover the sea. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
The fifth lesson is from the Gospel of Luke, chapter 1, verses 26 through 35, and then verse 38. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you who are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary. You have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be the great, and he will be called the Son of Man, the Son of the Most High. The Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever. His kingdom will never end." "How will this be?" Mary asked the angel, "since I am a virgin." The angel answered, "The Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. So the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God." "I am the Lord's servant," Mary answered. "May your word to me be fulfilled." Then the angel left her. May God bless the reading of his word.
Good morning. Our sixth lesson is from Luke chapter 2, verses 1 through 7. Now it came to pass in those days, there went out a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be enrolled. This was the first enrollment made when Quirinius was governor of Syria. And all went to enroll themselves, every one to his own city. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house of the family of David, to enroll himself with Mary, who was betrothed to him, being great with child. And it came to pass, while they were there, the days were fulfilled that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn.
Let us now sing together hymn number 103, Away in a Manger. Please stand as we sing together.
The seventh lesson comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 through 16. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. And this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Let us now sing together hymn number 100, Angels We Have Heard on High. Please stand as we sing together.
Mountain.
Please be seated.
For our eighth lesson, we turn to the Gospel according to Matthew in chapter 2, verses 1 through 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard this, he was frightened, and all Jerusalem with him. And calling together all the chief priests and scribes of the people, he inquired of them where the Messiah was to be born. They told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah, for from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called the wise men and learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. Then he sent them to Bethlehem, saying, "Go and search diligently for the child, and when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chests, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road. This is God's word for us this morning.
Let us now sing together hymn number 85, "The First Noel." Please stand as we sing together.
The ninth lesson is taken from John 1 through 14. This talks about the Word becoming flesh. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was with God in the beginning. Through him all things were made. Without him nothing was made that has been made. In him was life, and that life was the light of all mankind. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness has not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify concerning that light, so that through him all might believe. He himself was not the light. He came only as a witness to the light. The true light that gives light to everyone was coming into the world. He was in the world, and though the world was made through him, the world did not recognize him. He came to that which was his own, but his own did not receive him. Yet to all who did receive him, to those who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God, children born not of natural descent, not of human decision or a husband's will, but born of God. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. May God bless the hearing of his word.
Child of promise, hope of all. Good morning. I'm so glad you're here. Would you join me in thanking our musicians and choir for leading us in such a good day of worship today? Let's just give them a hand. Thank you. Thank you. I told him in early service, I have a friend who pastors a predominantly African-American church, and I asked him one day about how long their services went and how you decided about that, and he said, well, after some thought, I think it's just up to the pastor. So let us agree that we will be very brief for this part of the service. Is that okay with you? Did you hear what I heard this morning? Lessons from Scripture about the great story of the birth of Jesus Christ. And carols we sang together in our choir. Christmas is close. It is drawing near in 1 week. And I am so excited to share with you this Saturday night at our Christmas Eve Candlelight Communion, our sanctuary filled, and on the last verse of Silent Night, we raise our candles in the darkness, for the light has come into the world and the darkness cannot put it out. And Sunday morning, which is Christmas Day, at our 10:30 service, I will wear a not-so-tacky sweater, I think, unless it's just warm and maybe a t-shirt. Who knows what it's going to be like? We will come for a casual day of worship to sing carols together, to hear the story from Luke's gospel and a word of hope and encouragement. And I look forward to sharing that with you. When I was in second grade, I went to an elementary school where we didn't change classes for the different subjects. We stayed in the same room, except for break, for snacks, for lunch, and for recess. And I remember on one of those days, I took out my reader. It was time for reading. And I began to read my story. And somehow I was so engrossed in the story, so absorbed by it, that I just kept reading through another subject. I looked up at one point, and Mrs. Judd had already gone way into math. I was so embarrassed. And I looked around to see if anybody had noticed. I put my reader back into my desk and fumbled around and found my math book and papers and just got picked right up where I was with math. Have you ever felt like that before, where you have been so absorbed in something that you've sort of have the feeling you've missed what's been happening around you? Has that ever happened to you? Maybe you're driving down the road and you just zone out for a little bit, or maybe your anxieties and your worries get to you. Maybe you're so preoccupied with the task and the work. Listen, do not let Christmas pass you by. It doesn't have to, you know. Years ago, when I was pastoring in Tennessee, I asked our campus minister, Bob Ford, to come and preach our revival. And at that revival, we had a guest minister of music who came. He was the minister of music at the Methodist Church. His wife went to our church. So they combined the choirs. We were all so glad to have everyone there. And one of the songs he led us to sing was, "Pass Me Not, O Gentle Savior." It's a beautiful old hymn, number 308 in our hymn book. And after we sang it, Bob went down and he said, "Thank you so much for the song, brother music director, but I want you all to know Jesus will not pass you by." And that's true, isn't it? Christmas does not have to pass you by, but we must receive it. It doesn't have to pass you by. And it is simply this, for unto us a child has been born, a Savior has been given, who is Christ the Lord. I hope you have a very merry Christmas. Amen. And now for our invitation, you're welcome to respond to God in your heart as you are, to come forward and share decisions if you want to share it or pray with our church. We will sing hymn 93, a song I learned in third grade at Hoax Bluff, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear." Let's stand as we sing together.
It came upon
a midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their hearts of gold. His song
pray with me. Our Father, we are so grateful for the music and the message that we have heard. We pray, Father, that you will bless all of this congregation and those who believe in you with peace and goodwill. Father, we are so thankful for the many blessings that you've given us, more than we deserve. And we pray, Father, that as we give back a small portion of what you have blessed us with, that you will bless it to the ministry of this church and others. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him, all creatures here below. Praise Him above, ye heavenly host. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
Before our benediction, I'd just like to mention that in the early service, Graham Seagraves came forward to say that he wants to follow Christ and will follow up with baptism soon. So I wanted to let you know that next time you see Graham and his family. I ask you now to please join me in prayer. Oh God, we thank you for the hope, peace, joy, and love that only you can bring to our lives. We celebrate new faith, and we find renewal in that for our own faith. We sing and pray together today, O come, Emmanuel. It's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.
Hello, I'm Mike Oliver. I'm the senior pastor here at Trinity Baptist Church. I'd like to thank you for joining us for worship through our church website. And also, I'd like to invite you to come and visit us. This is a great church. We have friendly people here. We value worship, we value community and global missions, and their programs for children all the way to senior adults. I think you'll like our church, and I hope you'll come and visit us and see for yourself in person. If you have questions about our church, like to know more, we'd love for you to contact us. There's information on our website. You can call us or email us or come by, and one of our staff members will be glad to talk with you. Welcome to Trinity, and God bless you and keep you.